Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieco, and today I'm gonna cover 5 super obvious 3ds Max features that you either knew your whole life or you discovered them just now after 1,500 years of using 3ds Max. So let's dive deeper into the known unknown depths of 3ds Max. But before we continue with our magnificent tips, I first want to check out what's new on the Evermotion website. So look at this, Arc Models Volume 279, 12 sets of bedroom furniture and props. If you want to see more, click see more. Again, Evermotion Challenge 2023 winners announced. Did you participate? Did you win? You don't know. Click here. Go on the Evermotion website. And many other new things. Look, even my videos are here if you missed them, but I know you didn't. So yeah, check out the Evermotion website. Let's continue with our super deep depths. Our first feature is going to be paint soft selection. So whenever you're in editable poly mode and you go to your vertex or edge or poly mode, doesn't really matter. And if you want to use soft selection, well, did you know that there is a paint soft selection section? So when you click on the paint button, you can actually paint soft selections, and now you can manually get your desired soft selection. Additionally, if you click on the blur button, it's actually going to blur your selection. You can increase the size of the selection, but there's also a revert button. So when you click on the revert, you're actually just gonna delete the selections. So now you can actually get some organic kind of looking selections. So yeah, this is a pretty nifty feature. Our next feature is a little bit hackish. So this is actually a super old trick on how you can get square gizmos when using UVW maps without you manually adjusting them. So take a look at this. I have a teapot here and I'm just gonna click my UVW map. So as you can see, my gizmo on UVW map modifier is not square, but there's a little trick. So instead of you going to the gizmo and just try to make it look squarish, what you can do, just click on the spherical mode and go back to planar mode, and voila, you got your square gizmo. Our next feature is about booleaning splines. Now, splines already have a boolean, like built-in boolean in itself, and it's pretty basic, it's pretty rough, so here is how it works. Just go to your editable spline, and then the first thing you need to do is just attach all the objects that you wanna kind of boolean, and then you just go into spline mode here, scroll down a little bit, and here you have boolean. So how does it work? You need to first select your rectangle, and then click on the boolean, and then whichever you click, these are gonna kind of pierce your object, right? And that's it. But the problem with this is set in stone. So whatever you pierced in, it's done. But there is this new cool thing, which is called Shape Boolean Modifier. So how do you get that? So if I select my rectangle here, just go to the Create panel and here go to Shapes. And under the splines, click on Compound Shapes. So here you're gonna find Shape Boolean. When you click it, it literally looks like Max's Boolean modifier. So how does it work? Click on the add operands and you just add stuff, and each one of these that you clicked, so I added a circle and a star. So on the circle, you can change if you want it to be intersected, if you want it to be subtracted, doesn't really matter. Another cool thing is if I go to my modify, you can see that it's actually added as a modifier. So when you click on the drop down here, go to operands, you can now move things on the fly and they're gonna pierce your splines and it's gonna look very cool. Look at this. This is awesome. Now, speaking of splines, there's this other spline type that I've seen people rarely use, and it's called a section. So you have section here. So let me just show you how this section work. So you have your spline. Just create a section like this, so it doesn't need to be, you know, the full size of the object or something. So you just do this and take a look at this. When you move the section like across the object, you can see how that yellow line kind of appears and it looks kind of like some matrix kind of thing. So what can you do with it? Now, when you go to your modify panel here, you can click on the create shape and you can of course rotate it however you like. So for example, let's say something like this. So you have all the yellow lines, right? And you just click on create shape. And when you click that, you're gonna get the new shape window, and that's it. You got that shape. It literally pierced it in, so you can use it for whatever you like. But yeah, spline section is a really cool feature. I wish I knew that before because I used some really dumb techniques to do a similar thing before, like quick slicing and don't ask. Now our last feature is gonna be pimping up your quad menus. So look at this. If you go to Customize, Custom User Interface, you click on the quad menus, here you have advanced options. Go there and now take a look at this. You can set the transparency of your quad menus. So for example, my quad menu currently looks like this. You can set the opacity to be like, let's say 85, and you're gonna get that like semi-transparent quad menu. So yeah, it kind of looks more cool. On the other hand, you have vertical margins. So if you increase that, you're gonna get a larger spacing between your options. Sometimes if you have a lot of things in your quad menu, these things can look super packed. And having a couple of margin spacings, I realize it really helps me a lot. But yeah, in general here you can change the fonts, you can change the colors and all that random stuff. But yeah, the opacity and margins, I think they are pretty cool features. And our last bonus feature is when you hit X, you get, you know, the search window that we all know about. But did you know that you can actually add modifiers to your objects by hitting X? So look at this. I have this, just gonna write turbo smooth, bam, turbo smooth here. Bend, bend, UVW map, boom. And of course, if I want my gizmo to be square, I can just hit spherical and click on planner again, and it's gonna be square. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Evermotion, thank you for sponsoring this video. See you in the next one. Bye.